My name is Francisco Arriaga. I'm the Soil and Water Management Specialist for UW Extension and also a faculty member in the Department of Soil Science at the University of Wisconsin-Madison. And today we are at Arlington, Wisconsin, and we are near or right next to a long-term tillage experiment that Dr. Joe Lauer, corn agronomist for UW Extension, has been maintaining for the past few decades. What we have here is a system where we have a conventional tillage system that is chisel in the fall, followed by disking in the spring. And then we also have a continuous no-till system that has been under no-till for over 25 years. And a third system what we're going to compare, kind of as an extreme, will be the alleyway, which has been rototill 2 to 5 times during the growing season. Obviously, very little vegetation growing in the alleyway. So we have the extreme where we have very little organic matter residue going into the soil. And what I want to talk to you about is actually organic matter. And so what are the differences between organic matter between these systems and what's happening? So typically when we do a tillage operation, we are incorporating air and oxygen into the system, which tends to be a limiting factor for microbial activity. Microbes, they actually feed on the organic matter in the soil. So when you introduce that oxygen, that air, as you do the tillage operation, the microbes start growing and multiply, and they chew on, basically they feed on that organic matter, and that carbon gets released at carbon dioxide, as CO2, into the atmosphere. On the no-till system, we still have what we call the soil respiration, that process that I just explained, but it happens at a lower rate relative to a conventional system. Now, in a rototill system, we have the extreme where we're incorporating a lot of air, in this case, many times during the growing season. So we can see that the structure of the soils, which the structure is held by the organic matter, stabilized by the organic matter, is very weak compared to other systems. And I want to show you a little demo that kind of mimics a little bit of this oxidation that microbes do. So we can kind of get an idea and see, you know, the relative difference in organic matter in these soils, these three systems. So we'll start by showing you here. First one to my right, it's a soil that I took from the conventional tillage system, just from the surface. In the middle is the rototill soil, and then on the left it's the no-till system. And what are we going to do is add some hydrogen peroxide. This hydrogen peroxide is not the same hydrogen peroxide you can get at your local pharmacy. It's quite a bit higher concentration, it's a 30% hydrogen peroxide. And we have the same amount of hydrogen peroxide, same amount of soil in these cups, and we're just going to add it. And basically what's going to happen is that instead of the microbes oxidizing the organic matter in the soil, it is actually the hydrogen peroxide is reacting with that organic matter and oxidizing that soil organic matter, that carbon, organic carbon. This is actually quite a strong reaction. It's exothermic. You can see bubbles being created. If I were to touch these cups, you can tell that they're getting quite hot, sometimes to the point that you can barely touch it. And by looking at how this reaction, how aggressive they proceed, we can kind of gauge just visually and get an idea of the organic matter content on these systems. We can see that the one on the right, the conventional tillage, started very vigorously and is starting to kind of wind down a little bit. Similarly, we see the same thing with the rototill soil. And then finally here on the left, it is the no-till system, and you can see that that reaction is still going pretty strong. You can see that CO2 being released. You can see those bubbles where that CO2 is being released. So what we can conclude from here is that under no-till system, we're going to have a greater amount of carbon accumulation and all the benefits realized by having greater carbon in the soil and soil organic matter. All the benefits to fertility, chemical properties, and especially physical properties relative to a conventional tillage system. For more information, you can visit my website or you can contact your local extension ag agent.